It'll come back to Phaneuf. Here's the shot, and it's sailed high. Kessel settled loose in front, and it's poked high by Leupel on the doorstep and tried to go shelf and put it too high.
He went down the tunnel towards their dressing room.
Wonder if that means if he doubled up. Kessel, here's a chance for Steckel with a big stop there by Andre Pavlik.
Here's where Colby Armstrong gets tangled up with Derek Meach, and you see him go into the boards rather awkwardly, and immediately he gets up, and you see he's on the hobble all the way back to the Leaf bench, putting very little weight on his left leg. And as I said earlier, Armstrong is limping his way down the tunnel to the Leafs locker room where the doctors will take a look at him.
Anston back to Bufflin again. He'll fire it, and that one blocked by Lombardi. Matthew Lombardi has a shorthanded goal, little shot, and Reimer gets a piece of that on the short side. Bufflin again. Across for Enstrom. Bufflin now little up high. A lot of movement on the outside. Scores! Toby Enstrom! And it is the first power play goal for Winnipeg.
Absolute traffic jam in front of James Reimer, including Dustin Bufflin, who, once he moved the puck, got himself right to the higher part.
It's a pop. Kessel's got it. Kessel across! And a big stop by Pavlik off Joffrey Leupel. Leupel again, Kessel, quick shot, and Pavlik's got that, and he'll hold on. Couple of good control, and Bozak sending away Kessel. Points in four games, tied for the league leading scoring with nine. And a pretty good spot, off the post. Leupel, a gaping net, and now they're saying it's in. And it is in, Joffrey Leupel.
By Phil Kessel through the neutral zone, backing off the defense, and then finding Joffrey Leupel for a third time tonight. Leupel one times this into the middle of the net. It hits the camera right in the middle of the net. Pavlik can't get across on this one. This is a beautiful feed from Phil Kessel. Nice finish from Joffrey Leupel, and this is what the camera sees.
Yep.
And that'll pretty well put that camera to bed.
Very sharp back post view. It won't be very sharp anymore. He's here tonight. The rookie said he only had to pay for six tickets, right? Here's Keane with a good move. Shot, and Reimer stops that and has Keane looking skyward. Enstrom comes across and takes it off him, but following up, it's a pass for Canuck. Big stop, rebound, and Leupel took a whack at it, and Bufflin got his stick on it. Off Steckel's feet. Gunnarsson tied up. Jets come up with it. Andrew Ladd back in. And Reimer down. Paddle down. Pass. Rolling. Not able to get a shot off. Back for Scheifele. Shot. And Reimer stops that as Mark Scheifele looks for his first. David Steckel leans on his man, but the Jets move it to the line. Kept in by Shen. And a pad stop there by Pavlik. Alexander Burmistrov. Antropov did stay onside. Here's Antropov looking to center, scores! Alexander Burmistrov from Antropov. And it's 2-1, a close play at the blue line as Nick Antropov just stayed onside.
He uses all of his 6'5" frame to hang on the blue line, and then once he is on front of Keane on that race.
It looked like Keane had a step, but now it's Kamasar taking it out and shot this wide. Mark Scheifele was in. Penalty on the play. But Scheifele gets another chance and misses on that break. But Komisarek's heading off. And Winnipeg going back to the power play.
Komisarek gets stuck in the middle of the ice here. And he's going one way, but Kane's driving the other way with speed. Kane's going to get around him. And Komisarek takes him down in the middle of the ice here. Scheifele's in alone. And he wants to go glove side on James Reimer. He just misses it up over the net. There's the trip. And Scheifele has a golden opportunity.
Went across. And the return. He wired that one off the side of the net. He'll load it up for Big Buff again. McLean trying to return it. Buffalo shot. Rebound. There it is. Mark Scheifele has his first in the NHL.
What a thrill for Mark Scheifele. Last night we saw Rafael Diaz score his first NHL goal. This is almost a little different. 18 years.
Pavlik, the rebound got by Connoisseur. Gardner playing for the redirect or pass. Lucian Thornton knocked away. Dustin Byfuglien seen a lot of ice time tonight. Ian Edstrom playing the most minutes, and Byfuglien putting on a show here, powering in front, and Ryder robbing Brian Little after Dustin Byfuglien creates havoc. There's Wheeler working in, and Ryder got a piece of that loose in front. Ladd couldn't get it. Now Ladd again in front, and oh, Ryder just got the skate on that because that one looked like it was rolling in. He is now Lupo. Kessel shot, and that's caught off. Big stop, Pavlik, loose in front, centered, and John Michael Lyles couldn't reach it. That's a big stop by Pavlik. And now Lupo. Well, maybe the Leafs intended to have. There's the shot off, it's the win. Joffrey Lupo's got it. And it's a one-goal game.
Oh, terrible break for the Jets. Joffrey Lupo has it on the sidewall. He's trying to force this across to Phil Kessel. Enstrom's in good position, but when he goes to deflect the pass away, inadvertently pokes it through the feet of Andrei Pavlik, and the Leafs, on a second Joffrey Lupo goal, have got this thing back to a one-goal deficit. But that's a terrible break for the Jets.
So Enstrom's got one at either end now. John Michael Lyles and Phil Kessel draw assists. So Kessel now with 11 points on the year. Lupo has his fourth. And that for the Leafs, their first power play goal in 17 attempts. And it's back within one. And now Fratton trying to barge in. He's upended. And the Leafs are going to get back-to-back power play chances.
Now, if I'm David Steckel on this power play, I don't even look at the bench. Here's the penalty as Fratton gets tripped up by Derek Meech. Here's on the last power play. Steckel's taking the draw. He's like, am I supposed to come off? Nobody's even looking at him. So he's like, well, okay, I guess I'll go over here. As it turns out, now he's a power play specialist because he's taking the draw again deep in the Jets zone. Let's not forget with the Jets, if they want to change momentum here, Claude Noel's already used their timeout 55 seconds into this third period.
I was going to say, Ray, there's another faceoff win, 11 for 12. Steckel almost got him out of tonight. In front for Lupo. Pavlik down, and Steckel can't cash. Steckel 6'6", 215. Dion put up. Kessel scores!
The ineffectiveness of the Leafs' power play is born. David Steckel taking the draw, and he's absolutely wiped the Jets on this draw. He cleans Brian Little on the draw, gets to the front of the net. So there's one chance coming up, but Lyle starts his play with a beautiful feed to Dion Phaneuf. Phil Kessel has got his stick tapping before Phaneuf is ready to shoot this. He wants this puck. This is a tough angle, but Phaneuf head up, gets the puck on Kessel's stick. It's 3 points for Phil Kessel. The Leafs have tied the score. 12 more confident this year. Was really happy with how the Winnipeg coaches have dealt with it.
Quick pass in front of Kessel, robbed by Pavlik.
That's a great save by Pavlik. Robbed by a centerman.
Here's Kessel with a slot to the shot block. Rebound. Steckel can't bury it. Still loose. Pavlik was down and they couldn't get it by him. Close call. And again.
3-3 here. Late stages. Third period. Mike Brown stopped by Pavlik.
Another big save by the Jet goaltender. Back, rolls it a little deeper, and David Steckel will have it inside the line. Tied up by Little, comes loose. Phil Kessel wires it wide. What a chance for Kessel. Counter, Phaneuf steps up. Bogosian trying to warding him off. And, well, they almost had Pavlik going the wrong way. Grabowski stopped by Pavlik.
That shot, he goes over the pad on the blocker side with that quick release. Pavlik, though, is a very aggressive goaltender.
Well, is anybody hotter? Andrei Pavlik is, as he Ford's Phil Kessel on the first attempt of this shootout tonight.
And Kessel tries to go shelf. Pavlik's able to get the shoulder on it. And you know, Kyle Wellwood, with the shifty hands, will want to freeze Reimer.
And James Reimer holds his ground and makes the clock stop.
Wellwood wants to back him up here, and you can see he wants to go straight up over his shoulder, but Reimer gets the glove up to deny it, and Joffrey Lupul's got a couple tonight.
Four on the season for Lupul. And drop for Lupul to give the Leafs the lead in the shootout.
He's able to get in so tight to Pavlik. This is a terrific release by Joffrey Lupul as he freezes Pavlik deeper into the crease, and he goes right up under the bar. A perfect shot.
So here's Bermistrov, who has a goal tonight, the 20-year-old. Stopped by Reimer.
Reimer holds his ground well here on Bermistrov, who tries to back him in and beat him over the pad. And this will bring up Matt Fratton to shoot here. Now, Fratton was looking at my monitor on the replay on Lupul. He was staring at it like he's looking at videotape. So here goes Fratton's first attempt.
NCAA leading scorer. No goals in his NHL career for the win. He's got it! Matt Fratton and the Leafs come back to win in a shootout tonight.
The student did a good job. He studied Joffrey Lupul. He pulls it one stride to his left and throws it right up over the glove of Andrei Pavlik.
Well, a night for young stars to shine. Mark Scheifele scores his first. And Matt Fratton makes an impact, even if it doesn't count as his first. The youngster with a game winner in the shootout, James Reimer, the Morena Manitoba native, beats the Winnipeg Jets. 4-3, Leafs win it. So long from the Air Canada Centre.